Hello everyone, welcome to Aspen Fell, a place here in Second Life that is around for at least December. It's actually January 1st right now, and I found this place a little while ago, and I definitely wanted to show you it because it's quite a nice little place. It's like a winter mountain with some lodges, and for some reason, the Eiffel Tower right here, which we'll use the elevator to get to the next, get a little farther up. I'm not going to go all the way up because the elevator actually takes quite a while, as you can see. Yep, quite a while. There's actually like five levels, but this is only level one. But okay, we're here now. And we can see a better view of the entire region here. It's very nicely lit, I have to say. This is a very nice wind light. We got two ways to start from here, so we'll go ahead and start this way. Most of this is very much scenery. The trees are actually in a style that I don't normally see. You'll see what I mean in a little bit when we get closer to them. They're also... It's also off-region, I'm not sure exactly what you call it, but there is some stuff that you can use where you can make yourself, your region look like it has an environment off of the region, so that's why it's so mountainous, even though only the mountains close by are actually here in the region. As you can see, the trees, like, are textures. They aren't, well, not the dead trees, but these trees up here, the snowy ones, they seem to be textures instead of either sculpty or mesh. They actually look really, really nice for only being textures, though, but you can only really tell when you're very close to them. And there's plenty of places to lounge around. We can see the Eiffel Tower from here very, very much more than we could before. There's actually a grappling hook right here that you can swing down from way up there, but we can't actually use it at the moment, so we'll have to wait a while, but I will show it. There's actually a few ways to get off the mountain that we'll be going through. That's a good source of advanced lighting. If I didn't have advanced lighting on, then I wouldn't even be able to see that area light up just then. Some stuff down that way. I'm actually not sure of a path down there. But I guess we'll find it. Either fly down there if we have to. Maybe there's a way down this way? Let's see. There's some ruins here, though. hear a bell ringing, actually, right at the moment, but I don't know where it's coming from. I assume the tower. I don't think that's how you're supposed to sit. Whoops. Whoopsie. This has locked teleporting, meaning I have to fly back. Okay, we'll leave that seat alone then. Not sure what happened there. Nice little piano though here. Let's go ahead and head back over here to the other path. As I'm pretty sure the path up there ends, right? That ruins. Got a little village here. And a little vendor, let's see what it says. Hot cocoa and hot coffee. I guess cocoa and chocolate are the same thing. Let's take a look at these rooms while my frame rate suffers. Not sure what it is with this area, but my frame rate was getting hits earlier too because of it. Private residence. Guess these doors don't work. Oh, we can get a view over here. That was quite a big drop in frame rate right there. I just ran straight to the door. Okay. Actually, I do believe I've seen this building design before. So it must be on the market. See, can we read these? Either they're blurry or my textures are blurry. Ah, here we go. I think the one on the left is a chalkboard. This should lead us back into the mountain range, I believe. Nice view of the shoreline here. Don't think there's anything else over this way now. believe the only thing left to do is to look at the upper area. Alright, let's go ahead and fly our way up. I think we'll start over from the right. Okay, I stopped right over it. That was pretty good. Another deer. Nice little campfire here. Even got a tent. I believe we're almost up to this house up here. You can see the grappling line I was talking about. Now, where is the door? I forget. Let's see. And here we have a nice cabin. Plenty of wintry posters on the wall too. It's actually like a changing room cabin, I guess, for when you wanted to go skiing. Let's go ahead and take a look over the men's and women's room. Okay, it's just a bathroom. Nothing in here. Weird. They put stuff in one, didn't put stuff in the other. Okay. To get off this place, you can either go down the mountain by way of sled or skiing, or you can do the grappling hook. We're gonna do both, but we're gonna start with the grappling hook first. It's actually a pretty neat little thing. I don't think I've really encountered these before. I think maybe once. Although it's a bit slow too. You can see a nice bit of the scenery as you go by though. Alright, we're all the way back down here. Alright. I think I'll actually take a sled though. There's actually quite a few different choices to give you here. A bunch of weird ones, but I'll just take the normal sled. I never got quite down the mountain last time I was here. As I got stuck in a snowbank, but let's see if we can do it this time. Nope. Got stuck again. We were close to the big ramp off, too. Which is, I think, right up here. Yep. There's also another zip line down here, but not much point in using that when you can just sled down, right? And that about wraps up for Aspen Fell. It's a very nice little wintry spot here, very scenic. I'm pretty sure I went to another version of this that was made last year, but I never recorded it. And I will see you guys in the next video that I make. See you then.